next our concept is f printf and f scanf. This is also very very important question, and let us concentrate more. Okay, by using these function, it is used to read or write formatted data to a file. Please observe, formatted data means it is consist of a mixed data. Okay, also useful to handle mixed data with files. So it is also helps to display mixed data files. Okay, so that is the usage of this fprintf and fscanf. Let us see what is the fprintf function. It writes formatted data to a file. Writes means store. It writes formatted means neat manner data to a file. So it will store a neat manner data to a file. Then what is its syntax? If you observe the syntax, the syntax is fprintf followed by open curly brace, followed by the file pointer variable, format strings. Here the format strings means control strings and arguments. Arguments may be anything, either integer variable or character variable or string array variable. Okay, let us see here the file pointer to the file into which data to be copied, formatted string, format in which data should be copied to the file, arguments may arrays, integers or characters. So this is the syntax of fprintf. Then what is the fprintf function? It writes formatted data to a file. It stores formatted data to a file. And next one is fscanf. It reads formatted data from a file. So what is the purpose of fscanf? It access the value from an opened file, formatted data. Formatted data means neat data. Okay, then what is its syntax? Fscanf of bracket, file pointer, format string. Format string means your control string and arguments. Okay, your file pointer to the file from which the data to be read, from which the data of a file to be read. Format string, it may be read from the file, okay, whatever the format. And next one is arguments may be arrays, integers or characters. Okay, so then what is the purpose of fprintf and fscanf? By using this fprintf, it stores data to an opened file. And what is the purpose of fscanf? It reads data from the open file. Okay, so to understand this concept better, let us see here one program is exist. Okay, now let us see this program, we will understand. Okay, yes, now first hash include stdio.h. Let me copy this first. Even if we copied and if we explain, then fine. Let me copy, run notepad and paste it. Yes. So let us see hash include stdio.h, hash include conio.h. And next one is void main function. And next you are defining file pointer variable. What is the name of the file pointer variable? *fp. Here character array variable you are declaring. Okay, what is the character array variable? One is the name of 20 and another one is class of twin. Okay, and next you are declaring here, it is a sample program of fprintf and fscanf function. Okay, yes, now let us see here, int region number comma n float phi. Here we are defining float phi. Okay, so name of a student, class of a student, register number of a student, n number of a student and fees of a student. For doing this, we have taken the file pointer. First, for the file pointer variable, I am opening a file. Which file I am opening? Student file. What is the name of the file I am opening? Student. In which mode? W means we have to store. Got it? So first let us store the information in student file. Okay, first I am checking if fp equal to null, whether checks the file student is opened in write mode or not. So why we are writing this condition? We have to check whether the file is opening or not. Okay, yes. And next we are displaying, if the condition is true, file cannot be open. If the condition is true, then file cannot be open, message will be displayed. Else, If the condition is false, it will come to the else block. In the else block, we are writing or enter how many student information we have to store. So in your class, 30 students are there, right? We have to store 30 student information. So for that, we have written how many students. So we have to suppose to give as 30. Okay, ampersand n. N value is 30. We are reading the value from the keyboard and we have to enter 30 student information. Okay, enter percentile d student information means we have to enter 30 student information. To enter the 30 students information, then we are writing for loop. For I is equal to 0, I less than n. What is the n value? 30. Right. Now we have to read one value. What is the value we have to read? We have to read your register number. Your roll number or register number. Okay. So for that, to read the register number from the keyboard, we have to use the scanf function. Register number is an integer variable, that is why we are using the control string %d. After that, here fflush function is there. Actually, as you know, what is a flush, right? It is a loop cleaner, right? When you flush it, automatically loop will be cleaned in your basin. In the same sense, here fflush is the one of a built-in function. By using this built-in function, I am clearing the buffer. I am clearing the memory. Okay, after clearing the memory, I am using getS function. What is the purpose of getS function? To read the value from the keyboard. Okay, so here getS function is character array. I am reading a name of a first student and storing in the name. And I am using the getS function. It is a class. Okay, name of the student and class by using getS function. Okay, so it is an unformatted input function. And we are reading that value from the keyboard until unless you press the enter key. Got it? And next is scanf function. I'm entering the fees, your course fees, ampersand fee. Right? Got it? We have readed your register number, name, class, and fees. Now listen carefully. We have readed from the keyboard and stored that value in these variables. Now let us see here fprintf. What is the purpose of fprintf? It is used to write. What it is writing? FP. FP is pointing to the student file, right? Yes. So in student file, we are storing. What we are storing? %d/t, %s/t, %s/t, %0.2f. Okay. So please observe carefully. These are the mixed data type, right? %d, register number. We are storing register number, %s, name of a student, class of a student, and fees of a student. Okay, afterwards it will I value will be incremented. First student information has been stored, and next it will come to the next line. Okay, clear? Automatically control will come to the next line. We need not to be bothered about slash n. Got it? And here we are entering the second student information, name, class, and fees, and it will be placed in your student file. Got it? We are storing. Okay, likewise we are storing 30 student information. Next we are closing the file fp. If you are closing the file fp, means you are closing the student file. Okay, and next you are opening the file pointer. Fp is equal to fopen function. You are opening the student file in which mode? Read mode. In write mode you have already stored, right? Now you are opening the file in read mode. And once again you are writing the same condition, if fp equal to equal to null. If this condition satisfies, the file cannot be open, right? Else then what we are doing, let us see here. Else what I am doing, I am printing the information. Okay, I am displaying the student information on our screen. Where we are displaying? On our screen. Okay, where the information is exist, where the information is exist, it is exist in your open file, that is student, right? We are writing the condition now. While f end of a file, file end of a file of fp, until unless it ends, the loop will be continuous. Okay, so here already we have provided. Please observe here, while loop reads content from the file student until end of a file mark is encountered. So after reading the first record, it will move to the second record, third record, and fourth record, and so on. Okay, so now we have opened the file student in the mode of read. Now please observe fscanf function. What is the purpose of fscanf function? It is used to read. It is used to read. Read means accessing. Accessing the formatted data of open file, right? Which file we have opened? Student file. So here we are accessing %d, %s, %s, %f. So we are accessing register number, name, class, fee value from this student file. Okay, we are accessing. After accessing this, where we are displaying in our monitor, in our output screen. What is our output screen? Your monitor, right? So that is %d slash t %s slash t %s slash t 0.2f. We are displaying register number, name, class, fees. So if you have fed 30 student information till to that 30 student information, the process will be continuous. After the 30, is there any data? No data. So automatically it is treated as an end of a file, condition false, and it skips. Next, you are closing your file and you are accessing your records. Let us see whether it will work or not. Let me give as stu.serve. It is fsc.c. I'm giving it as a name as fsc.c. Okay, I'm giving a fsc.c. Let us check where it is there. Let me try. Yes, let me open our file fsc.c. So this is our file, correct? And let me compile it. It consists of 5 errors. Let me check it. What is this? Undefined symbol. Okay, hello. Yes. Let us see this execution of this program. Alt F9. Alt F9. 5 errors. Let us see undefined symbol I. Let me define it here. Okay. Comma I. Save it. Compile it. 4 error. F flush. So if you want to execute this fflush, you have to include hash include std.lib.h, okay, and compile it. Too few parameters. Let me remove this, save it, and compile it. 3 errors. Declaration was expected. Maybe these are the mistakes. Let me check while here it else f close of fp. Here these are the problems. Sometimes this comment also gives us some problem. Some problem is exist, so I'm not guarantee. Let me give it as a 2 students and enter 2 student information. 101 name is again second DCA and fees is 17,000. Okay, and 102. Maybe it is having error. If you try to execute this, it is showing like this. Okay, Okay, it is showing like this. Enter how many students? 12 students. 101. Yes, I'm giving name as a Pravin, and second BCA and fees is 17,000. I'm giving 102. Navin, second BCA. It is giving a mistake. This is sometimes it is happens because of this 64 bit. Okay, so if you try to execute this program, you will get output like this. Okay, if you try to execute this program, it will ask for the two students. You will enter this two student information and it will print like this. So let me check one program, maybe exist here. Not this, let me check seventh program. Yes, so here you will find same this program. It is the same program. Let me copy and you will find, okay, as it is this program is exist, and here it is showing it is an error. Because it is not an error, it is a mistake of 64-bit operating system. Okay, if you try in a 32-bit operating system, this will give correct. I am saving as py.c, and let me open for your understanding purpose. I will explain this program later. Okay, and see this execution py.c. If it is executed properly, then you will come to know. Okay, py.c. Yes. Let me compile it. Same program. It is asking for the enter number of student. I am giving 3. Yes, we have to enter number 101. Name is Praveen. Class is second BCA. Total is 450. And the 102 Naveen. Third BCA. Total is 550. And 103 Suresh. Third BCA and 650. So if you enter this, so it is displaying the content, right? So there may be a mistake in your program. Some of our programs are having mistakes. Don't bother about it. Okay, so we have to rectify that. I will explain the same concept of this program. It is the same concept of your program related to the fscanf as well as the f printf. Okay, this is fscanf and printf program. I will explain this. Got it? Okay. So hope you understand this concept. You should know what is the importance of fscanf and printf. So what is the purpose of fscanf? Fscanf is used to read the data from a open file, and printf is write the data to an open file, mixed data. Okay. Yes. So hope you understand this concept. We will meet in the next class.